I think it's very, very crucial to market test cricket like we do T20 or one day cricket. Because it's not only the job of the players playing, it spreads out to the management, then to the cricket board, and you know, to the home broadcaster as well, how you portray a particular product to the people as well. Because if you create excitement only around T20 and not so much around test cricket, then in the psyche of the fan there's already a certain template that's established. So I think if there's enough buzz created around test cricket, then yeah, there will be a lot more keenness to come to the stadiums. I'm a big fan of having more interactive areas for people during the games, like you have in venues when we play abroad. You know, there's something or the other happening, maybe a play area for kids, or you know, these small things will really, really help. Maybe school children could interact with Team India players during lunch, be on the field, play with them like we see in other countries as well. So I think all these things will really bring that strength into test cricket, and people would want to come and have an experience of a test match. It should be an event where you come and experience cricket, not just sit there and watch in, you know, hot conditions. So I think there has to be more for the fan. I totally agree with that, and it has to be marketed that way. Look, I can only say we are at the top of our game. You can't judge a team's dominance with 7 games. You're talking about a West Indies side which did it for 15 years. So, you know, when we all are close to retiring, maybe then you ask me this question. how the decade has gone of playing together, but not 7 games. So 7 years, yes, but not 7 games. I think there's still a bit of time to go for that. But we're quite excited about how we are playing and what the challenges are. You know, going forward, we'll be playing in New Zealand now. So now the frame of mind is to get to the next series in test cricket, and not like we've finished playing at home, let's see what happens abroad. We are waiting to play test cricket. So I think that mindset has changed, and now we know if we play well, we can win anywhere in the world. And that's a very exciting and a very nice feeling to have within the change room. You can praise our team on our performance, yes, but to say that we are dominating like no other team is a very subjective thing to think of, because if we have played 3 series so far, maybe if 4 series were 2 home, 2 away, and we had 300 points, then you can say, you know, yes, we're playing really well. But we are definitely playing good cricket, but I don't think there should be any kind of tags attached to any team. In the Test Championship, anything, even if we make the finals, there's only one game, so whoever plays well wins the championship. So it doesn't matter how many points you have at the end of the day. You have to play good cricket to win. But yeah, a good format would be one home, one away, and then, you know, you keep that balance and keep moving forward. Yeah, there has to be planning for a pink ball game. Although, see, we are playing in home conditions, but if you ask Bangladesh, they would also have liked a practice game before this game. You know, just because we know our conditions and our bowlers are bowling so well, so you don't really feel the challenge or you know, the things that are different about pink ball cricket. Maybe when we play away from home, we will figure out, you know, what could be even more difficult playing with the pink ball. I think it's in everyone. If you don't have hunger, you can't reach this level. The challenge is, when you perform at this level, can you keep the hunger going? So I think my job, or even Ravi Bhai and the rest of the management's job, has been to remind the players constantly, you know, why. Sometimes we forget in a difficult situation, especially as bowlers, when it gets hot and the wicket's not offering much, you know, you don't really feel like putting too much effort. But our job is just to put in small reminders as to why we started playing this game. It wasn't to, you know, sort of let loose when the pressure is high or the situation is not in your favor. And I think that shift of mindset has helped our bowlers pick up wickets on pitches that feel dead to other teams. So, and not just in India, even in Australia, I think that Sydney test that we bowled in, our fast bowlers were pretty effective and lethal there as well. So, you know, as soon as you get that reminder of why we started playing and that passion of playing for your country, it's a privilege. I mean, you know, guys realize that now, that there's so many players who want to be here, and these are the lot that are getting that opportunity. And as soon as you go into that zone, then you put in everything that you have, and then you see after the test how tired you are, not during the test.